In the Cold War, computers were trying and failing to translate between Russian and English. Now, I explored the American side of that frustrating early history of machine translation, but what were the Russians doing? Welcome to CompChomp, the only show on the internets where we like our sugars natural and our languages artificial. I did a collaboration with NativLang, and we met all the major players in the early computer translation boom in the US. The perfectionists who were like, rules, teach computers how language works. And the brute forcers who said, no, data, then let the computers figure it out on their own. Meanwhile, the Russians were busy making things even more complicated. Stupid American, simplify everything. Stalinist Russia had been standing in the shadow of a technology ban. Teach good theory, use good tech. But with Stalin's death in 1953, and news of that successful tech demo in 1954, Russians got in on the translation game. The Americans were mainly using a direct translation approach. You take a source language and figure out how to rewrite its words into a target language. Lazy Americans. This was too simple for Russia. Translating between two languages, why not three at once? All right, that's the last time I use my bad Russian accent, I swear. Leningrad University's Andreev built up a middle language that sits between the source and target pairs. Now this in-between language, interlingua in Latin, now who's smart, had features common to many languages. This interlingua was a real made-up language. A real made-up language oxymoron much? What I mean is that it was really, really made up, like it had its own sentence structure and its own word grammar. Now, I've been giving Russia a hard time here, but using a third language was not such a bad idea. When you pick a language pair to translate between on your favorite web translator, it's actually using an intermediate pivot language, English. In telling the tale of the birth of early machine translation to its death in that cold AI winter, I wanted Russia to have its moment of glory, because they were doing some cool translation work too, and we didn't have a chance to cover that in the other video. Let's be honest, you cannot talk cold wars and winters and not mention what's going on down in Russia. Over in Russia. Up in... Well, that's gonna depend on where you are. Chomp!